The history of the Civil War was written by white men to serve their own agenda. It's time for a black man to tell his own story. This is my father's story, told the only way I know how. The legend of Emperor.
You showed us enough men.
It's enough. We have 23 well-armed men. We only have a few guards. Once we get inside the gates, we won't have any trouble overpowering them. After that, it's just a matter of time. The slaves will rebel, and they will join us.
What if they don't come?
Have faith, son.
You aren't a slave. You are a prince of a people who come from a faraway place. Your grandpa was a king. And you will be a king. An emperor. Nothing will dent your will. Don't forget that, my little prince.
Thank you.
Don't thank me. I'll keep Grady off our back.
Hey, we out of seed.
All right.
Mr. Grady. We out of seed.
That ain't my problem. What you telling me for? Emperor.
Where are you going? Every night you go out gambling when you need to be tending to the plantation.
Come in.
Evening, sir. Ma'am. Sarah. We out of seed, sir. Now, we gonna need to get some first thing Monday morning or we gonna lose a whole day's worth of work.
I'll take care of it. Thank you.
How are you gonna take care of anything without any money?
I believe in the evening, sir, ma'am.
How are we going to pay for any seed without any money? Duane, we are in trouble. If you don't stop gambling, we are going to lose everything.
It's gonna be okay, I promise.
We've already lost everything my father left us.
Biddy.
What's wrong?
Master Duvain.
What now?
That man keep gambling the way he is. We ain't gonna have nothing to plant.
Why you worry so much and ain't your money?
I worry about us.
You can worry all you want to. Ain't nothing gonna change. That man is just a fool. Good night, sir.
Night, Aunt Betty. She right.
Figure it out. Same way I figured you out.
Oh, is that what you think? Shield. Every time he steals a book. Every time he steals a book, it's another chance to get caught.
He ain't stealing, he borrowing.
It's too risky.
Master Duvain don't care none. When we go up north, I want that boy to be able to read.
I want him to be alive.
What you've already borrowed from me.
Please, you know it is.
It ain't. Between Lincoln and this abolition talk, plantation values are dropping off, even for the ones that don't have a slave running them.
Better him than a white man you have to pay. Please.
Let's be clear. You lose this, plantation's mine.
Gentlemen, what are we doing talking? Let's play cards.
Thank you.
over here now. Get in the ring.
Good day. My name is Randolph Stevens. I am the new owner of this plantation, therefore, your new owner as well. Your new overseer is Mr. Hank Beaumont. This place has not been run well. Hank is going to help us remedy that. Hank?
Long as you work hard, follow me and my men's directions, we'll get along just fine. If you don't, well, that there is a whole nother story.
You may go.
Hello, sir.
What's your name, boy?
Shields, sir.
What do you do around here?
Me, sir, I help organize things.
Organize things?
Yes, sir. I help supervise the work, look over supplies.
Well, boy, your organizing days are over. Come tomorrow, you're gonna be out in them fields. I do the organizing.
Yes, sir.
What do you want?
So we ought to see. Now, in order to get any work done tomorrow, we need to get some. First thing in the morning.
How much seed do we need?
We need about 3 pounds of seed per acre.
How many acres need planting?
About a third. So we need about 6.
I know.
Yes, sir. All the seed we got.
Shields, is it?
Damn nigger told me the wrong amount of seed to get at the store.
Hank tells me that we're gonna be losing almost a whole half a day's worth of work because of you.
Don't want to work, you ask me.
Shields, how long you been working here?
Since I was a boy.
And how long you been helping order the seed?
Long time.
So it's not likely you gonna get it wrong.
No, sir. I think Master Hank might have got a little confused is all.
Yeah, but you ain't calling Mr. Hank a liar. Well, we want to set a good example here. String him up.
I didn't make no mistake. Save a little more. Till we buy our freedom. We almost there. We almost there.
Thank you. it hurt?
It ain't so bad. What you worried about your old man for? Huh? Sit down. You know I've been working. I got a little something stashed away. One day soon, I'm gonna take you and your mom and we're gonna go up north. And we're gonna be free. You know why they call me Emperor? Hmm? Because my granddaddy, your great-granddaddy, was a king. Now that make you a prince, right? Which means one day you're gonna be a king.
Is that really true?
It's true to me. All right? Still worried? Still worried? You sure? Huh? You sure? Come. You ain't worried?
Well, ain't this a novelty? Go on. What's it say?
Okay. Sarah. Sarah, what's wrong?
Ain't as bad as it looks. And once I put the ointment on him, he'll be good as new in no time. No, Sheriff, listen to me. Listen to me, don't do nothing. Please, don't do nothing stupid,
please. Shield,
no.
Shield. Come on. Not this time.
That boy of yours is a little troublemaker. Maybe. Next time, his daddy should do the discipline, and I will sprain my wrist.
Watch it, boy.
Your wife will get yourself killed. Country, that's why. We white folks, we made in his image. And in God's country, I can do whatever I want.
Hey, think about this, boy. You do this and you're dead.
I'm already dead.
Sarah.
Come on out now. Hiding back there ain't gonna do you much good.
Hand over that body, we won't shoot.
Y'all want with a dead body.
That's our brother, and we won't give him a proper burial.
Be ashamed to bury him. It's worth $200.
He's worth $200? Heck, we should think about turning him in ourselves.
What's wrong with you, Sam? That's our baby brother.
I'm just saying. What difference does it make? He's dead as a doornail.
What if Ma hurt you right now? How can you think about money at a time like this?
Because we ain't got none.
What'd you kill him for? He wasn't worth nothing.
I tell you what. I'll give you the same chance I gave your brother. Now, either you can fire that there rifle, or you can run.
I can go get a job anywhere. This ain't my first time doing this, you know what I'm saying? I just couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. And they let him get away like this. If I'd been there, a whole different story. And you take this bunch right here. Look at it. In line, stepping along, keeping the rules. And if I'd been there, and that nigga went crazy, Beaumont'd still be alive, that nigga would be dead.
Yeah, open up. Gonna be able to see him if he's down there. Come on.
You don't talk much, do you? They cut your tongue? What for? Talk too much. You been hiding out here?
This the hellhole swamp?
I heard about this place. They say a lot of runaways live out here. I can't stay here. I gotta get north. It's the only way I can free my son. You know about the Underground Railroad?
You ain't out there to rob me. I ain't liable to hurt you neither.
Hello, sir. I was headed to Greensboro.
Was wondering if you could point me in the right direction.
What business you got in Greensboro?
My own. Can you hit me or not?
You the one them white folks is looking for.
No, sir. You must got me confused with somebody else.
No, I don't neither. No, use him. Yeah, but don't you worry, your secret's safe with me. Everybody talking about you. Yeah. But if you come with me, I can help you find a place to hide out and lay your head down for a night or two. Also get some food in your belly before you head on to Greensboro. That's a long way.
Who about your master?
Oh, he away with family out west. You be gone for anybody know a thing.
Why is you offering to help me?
I like what you're doing. I'd do it myself if I was younger. Be nice if you could live through it.
Name Shields.
I know who you is. Emperor. Everybody know who you is. Truesdale, they call me. Come on, Jane.
Thank you. Who's there?
Who does it look like?
I don't know.
That's the fella everybody been talking about.
The one that killed him, white folk?
Yeah.
What you bring him here for?
So he can rest for a minute before he go on his way.
This ain't a hotel. Anyone find out about this, we gonna be in a whole heap of trouble.
Nobody saw us. Everybody gone.
You gotta go. You can't stay here.
Not Dolores. Now, if you don't let him be, I might have to tell Master Reed about you sneaking them sweets out the kitchen every evening.
That candy ain't nothing compared to this.
Yeah, well, it's enough to get you some lashes, and you know you ain't got the stomach for no whooping.
Ain't no good gonna come out of this.
Oh, hush. Go in there and fix our guests a bath. Ain't you got no manners?
Gone with you. So, sure what they say?
What they say?
Say you killed a bunch of white folk.
What's the matter?
Sin. God gonna punish you.
When I see it, God don't punish me for things I ain't even done.
Why you do it?
To beat my son.
You kill a white man over that? And that happen every day.
I took lashes my whole life. Kept my head down. Didn't cause no trouble. Thought that keep my family safe. But when I seen what they did to Tommy, when I seen the life ahead of him, I don't want him to be like me.
He was a brave man.
No. I'm a fool. I didn't think. I just went crazy. Because of me, because of what I did. My wife.
Anything else you need?
No, ma'am.
Hey there. You leaving?
Thought I'd get an early start. Get on the road.
Yeah, y'all stick around. Dolores can cook you some eggs.
Got a long road ahead of me. Best I get going before I get too late. Listen, I just want to thank you for your hospitality.
Don't thank me yet. You worth too much money to just let you walk away. No, you and me gonna sit right here and wait for your master. Get on over here. Get on over here and open up this cage. I hate to do this to you. That reward money for you's gonna buy me my freedom. Go on, get up in there with them pigs.
Just gonna send the overseas. They're gonna be here any minute.
Tell them I killed Truesdale.
What? No.
Hey, listen to me now. Come on. One more body mean no difference. They think you did this, they gonna hang you for sure.
Take Truesdale's horse. Go on now, go.
Randolph's murderous nigger is just a symptom of a larger problem.
You're damn right. This is liable to lead to a rebellion. And that's just what we need with all this abolition talk up north.
Do you think folks in Boston care any more about slaves than we do? They just need labor for their factories.
Why don't you kill his boy? That'll set a good example.
I've already lost one slave. I'm not destroying any more of my property.
You all may be in the business of casting blame, but I am in the business of finding solutions. Sir, step in, please. Gentlemen, Adele, Mr. Luke McCabe, the best bounty hunter in the state of Texas.
Heard you got a problem with a runaway slave.
This nigga is rampaging the countryside. Stealing from, raping, and killing good God-fearing white folks like it ain't nothing.
Tom, show him the poster, please.
$1,000.
$1,000?
That's more than twice what he's worth.
Well, the way I figure, not about one slave. And the longer he keeps it up, the more likely you got yourselves a rebellion across five states. Not that it makes a difference to me, of course.
Luke, give us one moment, please.
Give you $100, not a dime more.
It's a principle. I'm in.
I want to catch him, so I'm in.
We have no choice. I'm in. All right, Luke. But if we're going to be spending that much money, I'm afraid I'll have to insist one of my men goes with you.
Shields. You know him?
Yeah, I knew him.
Go on now.
He's a nigger. They's all the same.
That man escaped your plantation and single-handedly killed three of your men. Now that sounds pretty extraordinary to me. So how about you tell me something useful?
He was smart, I guess. Smarter than most white folk, even. They just about run things around here till Hank come along. And they called him Emperor. He had an attitude to back it up.
What you know about the railroad?
The Underground Railroad?
Uh-huh.
Just a way for a bunch of nigger lovers to, pardon me, abolitionists to get runaways up north.
It ain't no use. White men don't know anything about the stations.
I wasn't planning on asking no white man.
This man here made it all the way to Pennsylvania before these old boys nabbed his ass.
Don't kill me, sir, please. Don't kill me, please.
Please. If anybody knows, it's him.
What's your name?
Henry, sir.
Well, Henry, I just negotiated your life for the sheriff here.
Oh, thank you.
Now, all you gotta do to get this here noose off your neck is point out all the houses along that Underground Railroad of yours. Can you do that for me?
I don't know nothing about no railroad, so.
Suit yourself. Gentlemen.
Please. Wait! Show me that map again, sir.
Some nigga just robbed a bank.
How do you know it's him?
Two, including this one.
You always bring a load of wagons to a robbery?
I ain't never been chased before. I guess I learned my lesson.
Mm-hmm.
We make a good team. You ever consider going in the outlaw business?
Boy, I got the whole South chasing. I'm already an outlaw.
Oh, shit, you might as well make some money at it.
Here, drive! Drive!
ditch the wagon. Get on the horse.
God damn it, this is my house. Shit.
Did we get him?
Fucking gut shot.
Can't be no outlaw without getting shot at least once.
Think I'm gonna get credit for this one?
I was thinking front page news for sure.
I can't wait to see my face on a wanted poster.
Boy, he's gonna be a legend.
Sure wish I had a shot of whiskey for this.
Me too. All right.
Wait. You could have left me and took the cash, but you didn't. Why not?
You need me to get some heat on that wound before it get infected. Yeah?
If I make it, we split the loot 50-50. And if not, spend it on something nice.
Hey, nah. You gonna make it out. All right? Look at me. Come on. On three. One. Rufus.
What you doing with that?
Hush. I'll put it back soon as Tommy read it for us. What it say?
It say he robbed a bank.
A bank? Good God from Zion. He ain't in enough trouble, now he go rob banks.
They couldn't catch him. He got away.
Read on.
It say the bounty on his head. $1,000.
$1,000?
Shields.
You Levi Colfer?
We got half the state looking for you.
What my intention? Just running for my life.
My name.
It's not safe for you to stay here.
I ain't fixing to stay. I just need you to point me to the next station.
What do you expect's gonna happen once you get up north? You're not just a runaway slave anymore. You're a symbol. And they're not gonna stop until they make you pay. And your escape, and your escapades, and your exploits are putting your own people, as well as all the others that are helping, at risk. You've got to go to Harper's Ferry.
What's there?
An abolitionist who's caused a lot of mayhem in Lawrence, Kansas. His name's John Brown. But now the rumor has it he's headed here with the militia, and they're gonna fight.
Fight? Fight for what?
To end slavery.
I ain't fixing for no fight. I was just trying to free my son.
You hiding a runaway in here?
We have reason to believe runaway slaves residing on your premises. You mind if we come on in and have ourselves a look?
Of course I mind. You have no right to just come
save
in here.
Save me, old timer. He ain't just a runaway slave. He's a murderer, a horse thief, and a bank robber.
You know we're gonna find him. Tell you, you fire on that here wall. Don't hit me. Get the horses.
Like he crossed the damn river.
Gonna make the job a lot harder. He's in Maryland now.
So he's free?
For now.
You looking for this?
Around these parts, colored folks ain't allowed to possess firearms.
Well, I guess I'm in trouble then.
Well, now that'd be mighty hypocritical of us, considering.
Wait. I know who you is. You're John Brown.
I reckon that means you must be Shields Green. These are two of my sons, Oliver and Watson.
You've done half what they say you've done. We're gonna get along.
And this here is Dangerfield Newby, just joined our cause.
Glad to see you made it this far.
Yes, sir.
You should come with us. I got a friend I'd like you to meet.
I think it is.
That's right, son. That's Frederick Douglass. We'll march on Harper's Ferry and take the Federal Armory.
John.
The time is now, Frederick.
This is not what we discussed. You said you wanted to march Virginia's slaves to the Appalachian. Foolhardy, yes, but within the realm of possibility. But this... this is a steel trap from which you will not escape.
When we strike, and the slaves in the surrounding plantation hear of our victory, they will know we have the means to fight. Frederick, I need you to help us.
You're a brave man, John. You're risking your life, and the lives of your sons. But your optimism is a luxury afforded to you by the color of your skin. If you go through with this, you will only serve to make them hate us.
They already hate us.
Who is this?
This is Shields Green.
Ah. Emperor. What are you doing here?
He came to join our cause.
Do you realize you're going to get yourself killed?
Our deaths will be the spark that lights the fuse of rebellion.
It's easy for you to say that. The white men among your ranks can easily disappear back into their old lives, but the Negro men will be forced to suffer the full consequences of your actions. What you see is nobility in their deaths. They see only as futility.
What do they have to lose, Frederick?
If you follow through with this, you'll be risking all these lives. Think of your legacy.
I think of nothing else.
How does it feel?
What?
Freedom. I still remember my first day.
I don't know. It cost me everything.
I can get your papers, a whole new identity, and send you up to Canada. You'll be safe there.
Safe.
What is more important, Frederick? Freedom for one man, or freedom for all men?
This man will never be a slave. And yet he's willing to risk his life and the life of his sons so we can be free. No, sir. I cannot sit idle while this man fight for me.
We can't all fight this war with the pen, Mr. Douglas. Some of us best equipped to fight this war with the gun. I think I'll go with the old man.
It's an honor.
I do this for my son.
Your son would be proud of what you did today. Is it true what they say? That you're descended from royalty?
Well, that's what my mama used to say. Don't make no difference if it's true or not. Slave, master, king. They all the same to me.
Go to get some rest.
Good night, sir. Dangerfield. Hey, Dangerfield. Oh. What you reading, boy?
These the letters from my sweet thing.
Yeah?
Yeah. Soon as we settle up here, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna free her and all my kids. What about you? What you fixing to do?
It ain't my fault, you know. All I'm saying is, getting in shootouts ain't my vocation. Just because I hesitate a little bit, that don't make me yellow. Militia. Board farm boys, that's something to do. Where's all the excitement?
Crazy abolitionists took over Harper's Ferry. Marines is on their way. We're going to help them.
Abolitionists, to say.
That's right.
They're here.
Oh.
Come on.
Open the gates!
Open the
They're
gates.
Here!
I knew it.
How many? Thank you.
Close the gates.
Sir?
I said close the gates!
Close the gates! Close the gates!
I demand to speak to the man in charge.
I am Osawatomie John Brown. I am in charge.
Mr. Brown, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Robert E. Lee of the United States Army. I'm here on orders by President James Buchanan to demand that you and your outlaws surrender this fort. I'm willing to offer leniency in exchange for a peaceful surrender.
I hate to disappoint you, Colonel, but you're not likely to get a peaceful anything from us. Not while that abomination called slavery is still the law of this land. Not when Negro blood flows in our rivers and irrigates our crops. Not till every last man, woman, and child is freed from their chains will we ever surrender.
You are evidently a man of passion, Mr. Brown. I can respect that. But I'm not here to make moral judgments. I'm here to enforce the law.
And I am here to enforce a higher law, extolled, you might recall, in the Declaration of Independence. That all men are created equal.
Need I remind you, Mr. Brown, that the man that penned those words was a slave owner?
Are you accusing Thomas Jefferson, one of our founding fathers, of being a hypocrite?
Well, I read it. He didn't think colored people were men.
Who is it decides who is a man or not, Colonel? Almighty God or Thomas Jefferson? I'll go with God.
So I'm to take it you'll not go down without a fight.
Take it as you will, sir.
So be it. Send them in.
Yes, sir.
Company! Forward! March! Ready! Aim!
Let's go!
we do, John.
To the catacomb!
Round them up.
I'm afraid it's a little late in the day if you're here for food.
Sure hurt myself.
Whoa! Don't speak. Don't speak.
There's some food and warmth for you. Here's some water. Let's get some rest.
Father. Thank you.
Reverend, we looking for a runaway slave. This trail led us to your church.
Well, this is a place of worship. This is no shelter for runaway slaves.
Lying's a sin, Reverend. You keep lying, you might face judgment day before you get a chance to repent.
Militia coming down the road to meet us. Gonna get real bloody. You know, if you work with us, You could earn yourself some money.
What say you, Revan?
Well, I think that the church could always use a donation.
Well, God bless. Look at all these damn Nimrods, looking for their piece of the notorious emperor.
Who handles this?
I got nervous with his reputation and all.
You're in charge of these yokels. You.
Yeah.
Bring your three best men. Let's go.
Douglas. Paul.
sir. I'm here to see the owner of this plantation.
Randolph Stevens, at your service, sir.
I am here to buy the boy.
Well, tell me, Levi, why should I sell you the son of a man who cost me so much?
Because I'm going to pay you four times what that little boy is worth.
I have a man here who wants to meet you.
You're Tommy. Levi Coffin.
Did you know my father?
He's the one who sent me.
Why?
He wanted you to have what meant the most to him.
Safe now. We're gonna be free. Let's go. Could you please read this and tell me if you can publish it? I've heard you're good with Civil War books.
Is this a Civil War story?
Well, sort of. It's my father's story.
Did he fight in the Civil War?
He helped to start it.
Is that so? Is this a true story?
It is true to me.
There's something better I know there is than this pain I'm in. Somehow I'll get through it. There's something strong that's inside me now. I'm not going down. Somehow I will do this. I'll get through the night to the day that's waiting. I'll get there.
me down. I'll rise above.